Hi.
This is a video series on how to create a REST JSON server on Linux with Delphi using TMS XData. Since Delphi developers are mostly Windows users, this tutorial will show how to do it step by step from the very beginning. Thus, in this first part, I will explain how to install Linux on a virtual machine and connect to it from a Windows computer. If you already know how to do that, you can simply skip to the second video of this tutorial. Some parts of the video will be fast forwarded, like when waiting for the computer to install or download something. Okay, the first thing we need is to download and install VirtualBox. VirtualBox is a software for creating virtual machines that we use to install Linux on it. You can go to virtualbox.org, click download, and download the software for Windows hosts. After downloading, we can just run the installer, and just use the default settings for installing. Okay, we have now our VirtualBox, and now we need to create a new computer. And the next step is to download Ubuntu, which is the Linux flavor we are going to use. You can just go to ubuntu.com and click downloads, and we'll download the server edition. Okay, we have our file downloaded. It's here in the download folder. Now we can go to the VirtualBox and create a new machine. Let's call it Ubuntu. VirtualBox already detects the type of the operational system from the name. Let's click next. We can define the amount of memory. Let's keep the defaults. Create a virtual hard disk. Next, next. Let's create a file of size 40 gigabytes. And we have our virtual computer created. Two things that I like to do. First is in the network, I use the Bridget adapter, so this Linux computer will appear as if it's another computer in my network. And we simply now need to add the download we have, the Ubuntu ISO file, to our computer. Here's the file we have just downloaded. It's in our computer and we can launch it now. We'll just use the default options for the server install. We'll just keep pressing enter here. Here it asks for a host name. Let's keep the default Ubuntu, the host name for our computer, and the full name for the user. Let's call it user. And let's choose a password for it. Re-enter the password to confirm. Let's keep using the default settings. Confirm the settings. Here we choose we can choose some pre-installed software in the server. We just keep using the defaults. Still confirming default settings. Installation complete. Let's reboot the system. And we have our Linux server installer. We can just log in using the credentials we set up during this install. And you can see that Linux warns you that you have packages that can be updated. After the install, we can do some upgrades of our installed packages. using command sudo apt get update and apt get gist upgrade. We can clear the terminal. Our Linux server is installed and updated. Finally, the last thing we want to do is to connect to our Linux server from Windows, so we can then just work with it from our development machine, which is Windows. For that, there is a very popular tool for Windows called Putty. You can download it from putty.org and download it here for Windows 32 or 64-bit. Let's run the installer. Use the default settings. Let's add shortcuts to the desktop. And we have our tool here. We can configure a connection to our Linux server. First, we need to know the host name or IP address. To know the IP address of your Linux, you can go there and just type host name. We can type it here. And if you try to connect here, you see that we'll get a network error. For that to work, we need to install the OpenSSH server on our Linux. Okay, install it now. We can try to connect again. Putty will ask for us to save some information, authentication information in our Windows computer, and we can log in using the same credentials. And that's it. We are connecting to our Linux server from Windows. Finally, you can try to use host names to connect to Linux. It of course depends on your network configuration. In my computer I can ping the Linux server, but not from host name. We can find the host name of the server using the host name command again. And if we install Samba on our Linux server, in my network, Windows machines will be able to find the computer by host name. Okay, Samba is installed. And I can ping my Linux server from host name now. So from now on, I will use the host name Ubuntu for my connection. So for example, for the Putty connection, I can use Ubuntu directly. And we have our control of our Linux server from Windows. Okay, we have everything set up. This first part is over, and in the next video, I will show you how to create our new, very new first Hello World application from Delphi on Linux.